next century.
Praises to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rach HaKodesh. Double honors to the apostles, the bishops, and the elders at Great Millstone who rule well. Peace and salutations, as always, to the elect. Going into news and prophecy, where we link the things that are happening worldwide, all right before our very eyes. All right, if you're not taken by these many distractions, all right, it's clear to see, all right, that biblical prophecy is playing out, all right, and you can feel it in your chest, you can feel it in your spirit, that something big is coming down the path, all right, and the Heavenly Father, all right, is getting ready to use his left hand to make a move. You can literally feel that these devils are up to something, all right, well, all of these plans, all right, can be found out in biblical prophecy. As the scriptures say, wisdom, all right, is able to seek out witty inventions. And ultimately, the prophets of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai are sent here as a warning, all right, as a exhortation, as a warning, you know, as a call to come back, all right, for the scattered Israelites, those of the elect who have ears to hear and eyes to see. All right, I'm going to hear the new song and trust and fear in the Lord. All right, because that's ultimately what's lacking, especially amongst you Israelites, is fear of the Lord. And we're living in the times where, as the scriptures say, the prudent man foreseeth evil. Let's get that. All right. And he hides himself. Okay. Proverbs 22:3, a prudent man foreseeth evil, all right? And what is the definition of prudent? Let's look it up real quick. Act of showing care, all right, and thought for the future. See, when you look at our forefathers and our foremothers who offered up some very, very important sacrifices that, you know, were written down for our learning, as the scriptures say, the things that are written aforetime are written for our learning, so that we, through patience and faith, all right, can have knowledge of our power through his only begotten son. So the sacrifices that we're offering up, you know, when you come into this truth, all right, it's a sacrifice for a future benefit. See, so a prudent man acts or shows care, all right, and thought for the future. Now, when you look at how these devils operate and what they push on you, all right, it's ultimately for the now, all right? Even when you go into the serpent in the garden, all right, what did he tell the woman, all right? Ultimately, you shall not surely die. Enjoy the benefits of now rebelling because it feels good, it tastes good. See, this is why we are to touch not, taste not, all right, when it comes to the philosophies of the serpent, which are being presented right before our very eyes in a form of rebellion against the Heavenly Father. So a prudent man is wise, well judged, he uses judgment, okay, shrewd, sage, all right, sagacious, all right, cautious, canny, circumspect, meaning you're looking, So a prudent man foreseeth evil, all right, and able to foresee, all right, you have to what? Have foreknowledge, and that comes through what? The prophets who the Heavenly Father has set up in these latter days to give you an understanding of what is to come. And many of our people mock at it, they laugh at it, all right, just like they laughed at Noah. But when what he foresaw through the Spirit, through divine, all right, revelation, meaning the Heavenly Father revealed it through him, through his only begotten Son, through an angel, you know, awakening your mind, which you can see here at the top here, you see the one, you see 4:4, call Allah Yahbashim Yahshah. So a prudent man foreseeth evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. Okay? So there you go. And we're coming into a time where the prudent, right, those who have been out warning, those who have taken heed, Amos 5 and 13. Therefore, the prudent shall keep silent in that time, for it is an evil time. All right? And the Lord has created the wicked. All right? Everything has its purpose. This is the book of Proverbs 16 and 4. Yahweh have made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked, for the day of evil. All right, and as many people are, you know, getting on these podcasts, trying to figure out the Most High, mocking the Most High, saying, why would he allow evil? Why would he do this? Why would he do that? The prophets are here to give you understanding of the Most High, because the Most High is not this character you learned about in the world, in these churches, or in these different philosophies. Okay, the Heavenly Father's thoughts are not our thoughts. All right, and he operates in a matter, all right, that is beyond human comprehension. This is why you have to have a spiritual mind, all right? And you also have to understand what's going on in this world. As you can see here, Pope Francis, all right, is saying now Satanism is a valid pathway to the Most High. And if you look at what's happening as they get closer and closer to their plan to achieve a NWO, to hijack the Heavenly Father's creation, to have full control over the spirit, all right, which deals with the mind, which is where, you know, the likes of Elon Musk, you know, they're presenting themselves as these saviors, all right, but what they want control of is the mind, all right, where the spirit dwells, you know, so that they can ultimately link you to their grid and play the Most High, all right, and have eternal life for themselves, while you, okay, and human beings are changed into another form of human being, all right, being ultimately linked to this modern day Tower of Babel, all right, where they will have control over your thought, okay, and be able to track, trace, and control everything, all right. And as you see, as we get closer to the end, they're becoming more and more bold with their declaration of being Satanist. Again, when we read the book of 2 Thessalonians, as we'll get, we always get this man speaking to a particular nation of people, the biblical Edomites will come to do the bidding of Satan. See? And this pope, all right, or this whole thing of Catholicism, which means universal, right, bringing many pagan traditions and many, you know, wicked practices, all right, into one religion, so all can have, you know, a piece of the pie, so to speak. And it goes back to Constantine, all right, a Jake, all right, but ultimately they've taken that and hijacked it, as they've hijacked everything else. And now you can see that they're moving forward. And when you deal with the NWO, the Pope, all right, which is the false prophet in the book of Revelation, let's get that, Revelation 16 and 13. This is leading, all right, to Armageddon. This is leading to the end of this age. Revelation 16 and 13, and I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, okay, which is the Roman Empire, okay, and the Vatican, all right, is in Rome, all right, but the new modern day Rome is America, Babylon the Great, okay, which is ultimately the power seat of this whole beast system. And out of the mouth of the beast, okay, the beast system, all right, NATO and the EU, right, and out of the mouth of the false prophet, all right, which goes to the Pope, you see. And also, these can be looked at as the three city states. You know, the Vatican, which is in Rome, all right, the monetary system, which is in London, all right, and the military power, which is out of DC. They are the spirits of devils working miracles, which go forth into the kings of the earth and to the whole world to gather them to the battle of the great day of the Almighty. See, and this rebellion will lead to Armageddon. See? Because since this devil's been loosed from his prison, going back to the Renaissance period, since he's been loosed, he's been on a war path against the holy people, against the Most High himself, against his son, against nature, against life. Now they're calling for a one world religion, all right? A one world order, all right? Which ultimately is the modern day Tower of Babel. See, that's why this place is called Babylon the Great, which is at the forefront of all of this garbage and confusion. Okay? Habakkuk chapter 2 and 3. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it shall surely come to pass, it will not tarry. Behold, his soul, which is lifted up, is not upright in him. Whose soul? The ruler that will be ruling in this end time. Esau, who's the end of the world. His soul is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith. Yea, also because he transgressed by wine. All right. And his wine, all right, symbolizes his philosophies, his way of ruling, his policies, his witchcraft. See? And everybody's drunk off of that wine. All right. Later in this chapter, all right, let's see if we can get it. Habakkuk 2 and 15. Woe to him that giveth his neighbor drink. See, which this drink that he gives to the people makes them spiritually unstable. See? All right. And what it does is it takes you off the pathway of righteousness and life, which is the simplicity in Yahweh Shai. Order, nature, the things that the Heavenly Father set up in their order. All right, he, through his drink, all right, he you drink it and it tastes good and it makes you to feel like you're being in power, but literally you're losing power. See? Just like alcohol. All right, it feels good, right? But you start to lose judgment, all right, if you do it too much. Right, and ultimately it takes away, it dehydrates you. Right? Well, ultimately they do these things in a spiritual sense. That puttest thy bottle on him and makest him drunken also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness. And the nakedness represents people being without, all right, their ways, being seduced, all right, to ultimately commit whoredom, all right, against righteousness, against their power. Now, going back up here, because this is the point I wanted to make. It says, yea, also because he transgresses by wine, Habakkuk 2 and 5, he is a proud man, the pride of thine heart have deceived thee. Speaking of Esau, neither keepeth at home. All right. And what did we just read? For they are the spirits, Revelation 16 and 14, working miracles which go forth unto the kings of the earth. So they go all throughout the four corners of the earth. All right, working wickedness, man. And the Catholic Church is a big part of that. Going and throughout the four corners of the earth, sending, you know, their, you know, witches and warlocks, okay, to weaken these nations through wine, right? Who neither keepeth at home, who enlarges his desire as hell and is as death, and cannot be satisfied, but gathereth unto him all nations, and heapeth unto him all people. Shall not all these take up a parable against him, and a taunting proverb against him, and say, woe to him that increaseth, and that which is not his. And this is where we are. So he's trying to gather all nations into himself. Now, when you look at the Pope's talking points, all right, you can read this article, all right, but he's saying every religion is a way to arrive at God, including Satanism and paganism. See? And when you deal with the Catholic talking point, all right, it deals with all of that left-handed magic. They deal with the gods of the ancient Babylonians. They deal with the gods of Egypt, Canaan. Okay? The Greco-Roman system. All of those gods are ultimately being united in one to bring about a new one world religion. As you can see here, he's talking to children and people. Together in unity, hope. Okay?
Ci vuole litigare.
Yes, it's okay to discuss and to...
Tutte le religioni sono un cammino per arrivare a Dio.
Because every religion is a way to arrive at God.
Sono, dirò una comparazione, sono come diverse lingue, diversi idiomi per arrivare lì.
Sort of a comparison, an example would be they're sort of like different languages in order to arrive at God.
All right. This is going back to the Tower of Babel, which we always go into that, but we can clearly see that this is the modern day Tower of Babel being built. Okay?
Ma Dio è Dio per tutti.
But God is God for all.
E come Dio è Dio per tutti, noi siamo...
And we'll go back to that, but let's read real quick some of the talking points of the Pope's one world religion. Pope Francis has called for world religions to unite in several ways, including environmental protection to protect the earth. We all need to come up under one banner for peace and safety. Okay? Climate action. The Vatican has discussed a joint initiative to call religious institution leaders and civil society organizations to work together to protect the earth. This is all being what presented as a way to fix the earth, put aside our differences, and to come together under this new world, which you will be tracked, which you will have to have a particular device. All of these things are being set up. Ethical AI development. Okay, Pope Francis has asked the world religions to push for ethical AI development. Okay, freedom of religion. Pope Francis has said that all people should be free to choose and practice religion. He said that the freedom of conscience and religion is the most important right. So here we are. All right. Recently, Pope Francis submitted a document with Muslim leaders about there being a one world religion. You can look this up. All right. But again, when you go back to the Tower of Babel, let's get the book of Genesis, the 11th chapter. It was centered around Genesis 11 and 4. And they said, go, let us build a city and a tower whose top may reach unto the heaven. Which today you have these clouds that's going to collect all this data. All right, which is going to give them the power to track, trace, okay, anything else. It says, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the earth. All right, and that did happen. So they were trying to make a name for themselves. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men builded via the angels. And Yahweh said, behold, the people is one. And they all have one language, and this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. All right. So this was giving people the ability to rebel against the Most High under the guise that we are all one. And we're seeing this very system be set up right before our very eyes. This is why when you get Micah, the 5th chapter, all right, which America goes under the name of Assyria here, Micah 5 and 6. And this is speaking of Yahweh Shai coming to deliver us. All right. And the things that would be taking place, it says, and they shall waste the land of Assyria with the sword, and the land of Nimrod in the entrances thereof. Thus shall he deliver us from the Assyrian when he cometh into our land and when he treadeth into our borders. Because we know the devil is going to come after us, but this is known as the land of Nimrod in prophecy. See? And Nimrod was the leader of this one world order, Tower of Babel. All right? And his name, Namrod, means rebellion or valiant. All right? He's valiant in rebellion. So we're living in Babylon the Great. All right? And the modern day Nimrod will be fulfilled in Esau, Edom. All right? Which is now, all right, as you read, you can read this article and go into it. All right, openly declaring that Satanism is a pathway to the Most High and that all religions should come together for the greater benefit of the world. As the scriptures say, when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction shall come upon them. And let's get our favorite in the book of 2 Thessalonians, the second chapter. Right? In the 8th verse, and then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, the prophets, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. See, and the prophets going out speaking has leading to everybody's waking up to this devil. Even his own kind. Even Eddie Griffin, a comedian, even certain comedian, people are waking up. They're talking about the MOTB. And shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders. And that those lying wonders would point to his ability to do miracles, his ability to, you know, tap into certain aspects of the brain to heal people. This man will come to do the working of Satan with counterfeit power, signs and miracles. And a big part of them being able to tap into that left hand, okay, is that Catholic Church, all right, which is known as the false prophet, all right, here in the book of Revelation, all right, the 16th chapter. And there's other scriptures that speak on it as well, okay? So when we look at what they're doing as they're putting all of these distractions in front of you, all right, you just had another so-called attempt on Donald Trump's life. You got many distractions out there, all right? But they're preparing a solution, all right? To all of these various different actions that you see, okay? EU's new juice card set, all right, is step towards mandatory juices and restrictions on freedoms. So they're setting up a system to where your freedoms will be restricted, all under the guise of peace and safety, all under the guise of things are getting out of hand. And as we see, all right, there's more and more, all right, talk of more dimmicks. When I say dimmick, all right, you should know what that's talking about. All right, more of these sicknesses being spread. Okay, every time you look up, there's a new, all right, something to look out for. There's a new sickness, there's this, there's that. Okay, these are all ploys by the left hand, right? So that people ultimately will submit to this system that they have set up, which leads to what John the Revelator saw in Revelation, the 13th chapter. Where the only way you will be able to buy and sell is to have this particular mark. Okay? So now, okay, as you can see here, they're setting it up, all right, in the beast, to where you're going to have a particular identification that will let them know, all right, what you've had, who you are, what you about. Okay? We can get to that. But printed cards, mail copies, digital version of, for smartphones. All right, piloted in 5 countries. All right, and people are rebelling, don't comply. All right, but as you can see here, Let's get it. Let's pull this up. All right, this is John Williams. It's now law, digital IDs required for travel in less than 90 days.
Hey, what's up, guys? John here. The EU has just brought forward into law a digital ID.
EU's much-delayed new border control system means that non-EU nationals, including people from the UK, will have to register their fingerprints and a photo before being allowed into the bloc.
If you're thinking about traveling to the UK, you're going to need one in less than 90 days. They've issued a date sometime in November. It's not a firm date just yet, so it's actually going to be 70 days from now. You know, this is here. This is basically right now. In America, they're bringing forward something called the Real ID, which is coming into law next year. You'll need this to travel anywhere throughout America.
Changes are coming to travel requirements if you want to fly within the United States.
The new deadline for domestic flyers is now May 7th, 2025.
Make sure your state-issued driver's license or ID card is Real ID compliant, and if you don't, you won't be able to board flights or access federal facilities.
Now, they've talked for a very, very long time about, you know, social credit and things like that. And, you know, a year, 2 years, 3 years ago, that would have seemed far-fetched, tinfoil hat type of conversation. But now, you know, it's getting a lot more real. It's getting a lot more real. A Chinese-style social credit system is coming to America. This came out May of 2024.
A Chinese-style social credit system is coming to America. And they've been talking about this. See, but, you know, they're calling on their guys. They're dealing with the left hand. They're putting out distractions. But this is where everything is going. You will have to be identified on their grid in order to travel, in order to move about. All right. And within that, your footprint will be tracked. Okay. As far as what you eat, what you watch, what you have access to, what you buy, what you sell, and this will all be done, all right, for the purpose, all right, of creating a better environment and protecting the world. This is how it's all being presented. This is what it's all coming to. They come at you in so many different angles and ways that you just say, forget it, but we here are here to bring it all together. It's so much that this devil has going on, and so many meetings he has. Even when you look at this gathering here, what are they doing? Okay, what are they doing in the UN? What are they doing at the World Economic Forum? What are they doing at the Bilderberg? All right, it's so many meetings. It's so much that they got going on. It's hard to put a finger on who rules what and what, you know. But what's going on is that these different devils, all right, as they're meeting, they're calling on their gods, all right? And what they're doing, as it says in the book of, let's get Isaiah 14, or Isaiah 47, rather. So much going on, it's hard, all right? And this is what ultimately they want. You see all of this and you just say, fuck it, you know what? You believe them, you be like, you know what? The earth is heating up. You see all of these things happening, your mass shootings, okay, people just dropping dead. You're like, you know what? We need protection. We need to accept. Let's just submit to what they got going on because there's so much confusion. The Tower of Babel, a stronghold of confusion being used to lead you into this path where you just submit and give up all of your rights, okay? And enter into their new world where now they're God. See? Isaiah 47:12. Stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries, which the Catholic Church is a big part of that. Okay? Wherein thou hast labored from thy youth. If so, thou shalt be able to profit. If so, thou mayest prevail. And as the elder Require Quam said, these plans have been in place for a long time, but when you go to 1776, okay, when the Bavarian Illuminati was conceived, you know, because America came out of the British, but these devils have been had this plan, and everything that we've been presented with, all right, is a tool, all right, to get you used to this system, to get you dependent on this system, But it's all witchcraft. These are all enchantments, credit cards, everything we see. They've got you used to a way of living on the planet Earth that is totally against the Most High. It's totally not what he intended. All right, it's totally dependent on you not being able to be in righteousness, man. You have to depend on a social security number. You have to depend on an ID card. You have to renew this. You have to do this. You cannot be in this system. See, it is meant to be that way so that now they can bring you a sense of, what's the word I'm looking for? All right. What's the word I'm looking for? Damn. It's a particular word I'm looking for. All right. Like a microwave, you know, a sense of, I can't think of a word right now. My brain is escaping me, but you get what I'm saying in the sense that it makes it easier for you. Okay? They've put all of these blocks and this and that, all right? But they're now bringing in a system where everything will be easier for you, all right? Damn it. Anyway, Salakia had a brain freeze. Anyway, it says, stand now with thine enchantments and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth. If so, thou may be able to profit. If so, thou mayest be able to prevail. Let's see if you're going to be able to prevail. Let's see if you're going to be able to ultimately outdo biblical prophecy. Because in the prophecies is your downfall. In the prophecies is your plan. You planning to do this. And also in prophecy is the Lord destroying your plan. Just like he destroyed the ancient Tower of Babel. Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers, stargazers, and monthly prognosticators, all right, stand up and save thee from these things which shall come upon thee. So they are wearied in the multitude of thy counsels. The word counsels. Let's go here. Itaza, advice, purpose, counsel, counselors, meaning they're meeting. Okay, they're meeting. You see all of these meetings, all right, forums. And they're weary, all right, trying to figure out a way, all right, how they're going to come at this word. All right, consult to give advice, propose, devise, plan. See, they're planning, they're consulting together. Okay, and that's in the book of Psalms 83. Let's get that real quick. Psalms 83 and 2, for thy enemies make a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and have consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. And when you read about this thing with the X chromosome being disappearing, when you look that up, the Y chromosome, I believe, all right, the Y chromosome is they're talking about is slowly disappearing, all right, but what that's going to give them the ability to do, all right, is wipe off the nations that the Heavenly Father created. And the main nation that they want to wipe off is the nation of Israel, because the Y chromosome is possessed, all right, by the man, which the seed determines nations. Okay? So the Y chromosome is slowly disappearing, because ultimately they want to wipe out nations which are determined by the seed of their fathers. See? So they have a lot going on. See, let's go back here and play this. But a Chinese-style social credit system is coming to America.
Came out just a few months ago. Then they kind of peppered this in a few years ago, saying America's...
And let it be known that the Israelites are the ones who started from 2007 going forward doing videos like this, where we go into the articles and, you know, even doing videos in front of, you know, water, doing videos in the car, The Israelites started all of this. But, you know, everybody else catching on and doing it as well, it only works to our benefit. All right, their own mouths are coming up against them. There's so many people, so much information. This is why the devil is on this war path against free speech, because he's being exposed. And really what the devil is up against is, how are you going to separate what you're doing, all right, from what the Bible said you would be doing? How are you going to do that? How are you going to get out of even the judgment prescribed? See?
The own social credit system coming soon. Well, it's here now. It's here now. I'm going to break this down and show you. I mean, look at the website. Doesn't get any more legit than this. Gov.uk. Gov.uk. Please hit the like button. Hit the like button. People share the content. Educate more people about what's actually sponsored by my company, GreatCreditFast.com, or tomorrow. So the EU entry exit system. Information and advice on the new EU entry exit system came out 2 days ago, September 24th. September 5th, 2024. From autumn 2024, the EU will be introducing a new digital border system to strengthen the security of its external Schengen border.
So they allow all of these migrants over, all this chaos, you're putting people in jail for speaking against it. And now the solution comes to, well, okay, well, this will fix the problem. We need to identify, everybody needs to be identified to be here. You come over here, you need to be identified. This will fix the problem.
The new registration process, called the Entry Exit System, or EES for short, is expected to be introduced in November. However, the EU has yet to confirm a specific date for its introduction. It will apply to those traveling to Schengen area, which encompasses all EU countries except for Cyprus and Ireland. Additionally, the non-EU states, Iceland, Norway, Switzerland, and Liechtenstein, are also part of this area. This will require most citizens of countries outside of the EU to create a digital record and register their biometric details, such as providing fingerprints and having their photo taken, which when they enter the Schengen area. This should only take a few minutes for each person to do. British travelers...
Inconvenience is the word that I was looking for. All right, this is all convenience. It gives you convenience around all of the systems he put in place to frustrate you.
Will need to do this on their first visit to the EU after EES is introduced. Their record will be checked on point of entry into the Schengen area, verifying either their fingerprints or photograph.
And this is that biometric. You know, we'll go back to this, but we showed you this, all right? That's all a part of it, all right? EU to begin deporting visitors who don't have Gil Bates digital ID, okay? The automated border control system, all right? And this is going to be brought over here as well with all of these migrants now, you know, they're forcing these narratives that they're taking over apartment buildings, that they're eating cats, eating ducks, you know, creating another enemy. All right. But eventually they're going to bring a solution to all of these problems they're creating. All right. And biometric data, including footprint, facial images, and everything, so you can be identified, is going to be vital. Okay, so the EU, which is the beast, is pushing forward, all right? You can read about more of these things. We don't have all of the time in the world, all right? Deporting visitors is the first step. Deporting citizens is the next. I wonder where we are going to be deported to. Maybe that's the purpose of all these Chinese ghost cities. Goodbye, European vacation. Well, this is going to be worldwide. Okay, there's going to be a worldwide system. This is the modern day Tower of Babel, all right, brothers and sisters. Okay, where all people will be required to be one. Remember in Habakkuk, he gathered unto himself all nations and heapeth unto himself all people. Now, it's a very stupid plan, but it's a plan that they have. Okay, now let's see here. See what we got here. Elon Musk caught plotting with WEF to eradicate sovereignty. See how he's set up as this, you know, he's against with what all of these devils are doing, but he's actually for it. And we've been telling you that. While Elon Musk puts on a public show on Twitter portraying himself as just one of the people, behind the scenes, he's providing global elites with the technology they need to infiltrate our minds, setting the stage for total control and enslavement of humanity that they crave. This is where it's all going, man. Okay? He's all a part of the plan. Let's watch this video, see what we can get here.
As Elon Musk puts on a public show on X, portraying himself as just one of the people, behind the scenes, he's providing the global elite with the technology they need to infiltrate our minds, setting the stage for the total control and enslavement of humanity that they crave. For those who are truly observing the behind-the-scenes developments...
And look at this guy. The upside-down cross Baphomet. He had one jacket on the back of it. It said New World Order. He's all for it. Okay? And that whole Neuralink thing is a part of what John the Revelator saw as well. Okay, the C-hip and brain.
Musk's behavior should come as no surprise. Because in reality, Musk is far from the self-made independent maverick he claims to be. Before we dive in, join the People's Voice Locals community if you haven't already, and sign up to become a member of the world's graduating in the same class as figures like Emmanuel Macron, Jacinda Ardern, and Justin Trudeau. All of them went on to become far-left authoritarian leaders in WF...
See, all of these devils are in cahoots, but they send them out on different missions, right? To ultimately bring forth the workings of Satan, man. Okay?
Infiltrated countries. Musk has tried to distance himself from Clash World in recent years, but that's easier said than done, especially with his brother Kimball, who he's closely tied to, being an active member of the WEF. To make matters worse, Linda Yaccarino, the woman he appointed as CEO of X, is also deeply involved with the WEF.
This is the heathen raging. See? When you read Psalms 83, the crafty counsel, all right? Psalms 83 and 4, they have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance, for they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. One consent, but they all have these different facets to confuse you, to make you look here, look there, and it's so confusing that you'll just ultimately give up. But see, the Lord has the prophets and he has particular people. All right, like this individual we're looking at this website, who are onto him, bringing these things out. Okay? These people are playing with billions and trillions of dollars, and they're all meeting, and they're all anti-Messiah.
As Elon Musk puts on a public show on X, portraying him...
Salaki, let me get back to the point here.
Also deeply involved with the WEF. So, who is Elon Musk really? Is he truly committed to restoring free speech? And what's his real agenda? Musk is a master of PR, constantly making headlines across the...
And him and Trump are being set up as these leaders, as these saviors. And you stupid people really believe it.
Globe. One day he's building electric cars. The next, he's launching rockets to Mars. He's got 10 kids, is the richest man on the planet, and can super...
And he's not the richest man on the planet. That's another thing. They put these people in front of you, the richest man on the planet. You won't see the richest man on the planet. Okay? You're not going to see him, all right, arguing on Twitter, you know, being threatened to be put in jail. You're not going to... He's not the richest man in the world. Get that out of your heads. All right? But people see this and they really believe it, man. This is all a show being put in before you, but there's a real agenda behind it all is what we're showing you.
Become the world's first trillionaire. In November 2022, Musk celebrated his purchase of Twitter by showing up to Heidi Klum's...
The world's first trillionaire. Come on, man. You got people that surpass letters when it comes to money. Okay? It's past trillion and gazillion. They don't even have a letter behind the wealth that they have. Okay?
Trump's Halloween party in a satanic-themed outfit, accompanied by his mother, May Musk. The red and black outfit worn by Musk featured an image of Baphomet, carved into the chest plate with an upside-down cross between its horns. May Musk seemed completely at ease with her son wearing a satanic outfit. After all, she has her own history of satanic-themed outfits and blatant Illuminati symbolism. Despite dropping hints about who he really serves, Musk has a legion of supporters who believe that despite being on track to become a trillionaire, he somehow stands outside of the corrupt system. Surely, they say, he's not one of them. Let's survey the evidence. Musk's support for a transhumanist future aligns with Klaus Schwab's vision as...
transhumanist future. And this is not medical information, we're just in the news.
Outlined in his book, The Fourth Industrial Revolution, Schwab explores how the physical and digital worlds could merge, challenging ideas...
the physical and digital worlds merging. Okay, and this is what John the Revelator saw at the very end of this system that starts with the Greeks... all right, was a powerhouse through the Romans, all right, eventually fell, all right, and revived through America, which added a beast system to it, the NATO and the EU. Okay, they would eventually, in the very end, force the image of Rome, okay, and through their policies, through their way of governing, and they would have miracles and technology, all right, but... he would eventually cause all, both small and great, rich and poor, to receive a chiragma in their right hand or in their foreheads, marking transhuman, meaning you're transforming past a human. And see, if you transform past a human, then you're no longer a nation tied to the Bible. You're no longer an Israelite, an Edomite, a Moabite. You're a new creation, right? And this chip, before we finish that, I mean, everywhere you go, you see it being brought forth. Okay? Let's see here. Everywhere you look. New currency. Let's see. There's a few videos I had, but... I mean, this is a good one. Let's listen to a little bit of this.
And there's a lot of people, you know. Designed to sort of try and get people, Americans, really engaged with electoral politics again, because I think most people have been really burnt out and really disillusioned with both parties. And I think you're going to continue to see both parties attempt to energize their bases by very perhaps unconventional means, or, you know, doing stuff that maybe they haven't done before. But, you know, either way, I think, you know, regardless of who wins, you know, ultimately a lot of the same people are going to get what they want, because at the end of the day, so much of the stuff that the American people are tired of are really bipartisan agendas. Right. And, you know,
two horns like a lamb. Right.
Regardless of who's in office, you know, when there's a crisis, the same people tend to be called upon to solve the crisis. So, you know, a good example of that would be the 2008 economic crisis. You know, BlackRock was basically sent in to help handle the banker bailouts. And then during COVID, when Trump was in office, you know, BlackRock was brought in to essentially design the COVID fiscal policy, which the ramifications of which we're still dealing with. You know, that's just one example. But you know, there's so much, whether it's funding wars or funding, you know, the state of Israel, for example, with billions of U.S. tax dollars and things like that. There tends to be bipartisan consensus about a lot of things. But I think, you know, there's an effort to sort of frame this as an election that's not that. And, you know, each group in their particular, you know, partisan silos, you know, think their candidate is going to be the answer and magically reverse all of this stuff. But unfortunately, you know, both are essentially, you know, bankrolled by, you know, major forces in Silicon Valley specifically. And a lot of those Silicon Valley oligarchs tend to double as contractors to both the military and also intelligence communities. And so, you know, maybe you'll have sort of the PayPal mafia crowd behind Trump this time, maybe because of J.D. Vance, but he's got, you know, David Sachs and Elon Musk and people like that in his corner. And even though Peter Thiel's being quite quiet, there seems to be some overlap there as well, which we can get into later. And then, of course, on the Kamala side, you have people like Reid Hoffman and Eric Schmidt, you know, who are also share a lot of overlap with the oligarchs on the other side, like Eric Schmidt and Peter Thiel.
Now, what is an oligarch? A small group of people having control of a country, organization, or institution, all right? And the elites... ultimately, they want control over everybody, but the elites don't agree. All right, but let's keep listening.
sit on the steering committee of the Bilderberg Conference, which is kind of notorious for being a closed-door meeting of a prominent, you know, globalist in the corporate world and in the public sector, you know. And Reid Hoffman and David Sachs and Elon Musk are all part of the so-called PayPal mafia. They just happen to fund different parties, and all of these oligarchs at the end of the day, do they frame the reasoning for why they want these policies differently? They agree about more biometric surveillance, they agree about digital ID, and they ultimately agree about programmable surveillable currency. Whether
see that? So no matter who gets elected, they're all backed by people who want what? Let's listen to her again.
For being a closed door meeting of a prominent, you know, globalist in the corporate world and in the public sector, you know. And Reid Hoffman and David Sachs and Elon Musk are all part of the so-called PayPal mafia. They just happen to fund different parties, and all of these oligarchs at the end of the day, do they frame the reasoning for why they want these policies differently? They agree about more biometric surveillance, they agree about digital ID, and they ultimately agree about programmable surveillable currency, whether it's a CBDC or a private bank digital currency that's also surveillable and programmable. So, you know, if you're against those things as policies, it's important to pay attention to the policies and not so much the campaign rhetoric, because people tend to forget, you know, during a campaign season that campaigns are essentially sales pitches, and very few people, when they campaign, actually keep their campaign promises once and all.
Right. So no matter what happens, she's on point. You can watch this whole video. It's real good. I got through most of it, but, you know, it's, time is of the essence. It's hard. But, you know, I got out of it. All right, basically, whoever wins, the policies that they're presenting to you, that they're talking about, that, you know, they ain't gonna do that shit. It's all gonna lead to what? Biometrics. What is biometrics? All right, involving automated recognition of individuals by means of unique physical characteristics, typically for the purposes of security. Okay? Biological data, all right? Being tied to your money, being tied to your ID, being tied to how you operate in the world. You're going to have to give over your bio, all right? Your physical to the digital. You're going to bring the two together. That's the what they're doing. Okay?
So this is a bit of an emergency broadcast regarding the digital IDs. Yesterday in Canada, Justin Trudeau met with all of our provincial premiers and basically told them that we will not be able to get funding for our healthcare unless the premiers agree to the digital IDs. I will show all the proof. Now, those of you who think that digital IDs are great, they are not. Let me show you what these digital IDs will actually entail when it comes to control. Here's an overview basically of everything that will be included in the digital IDs. This can be found on the WEF website and also on all of the provincial and government websites. You will have healthcare. You will not be able to access any healthcare without this digital ID. Financial system. You will actually not even be able to carry out bank accounts or carry out anything online regarding financial transactions. Food and sustainability. This says for farmers and consumers, you will not be able to get into stores. You will not be able to even sell anywhere. Once they have this system in place, this is where the digital currency will come in. Travel and mobility. We saw that with the Arrive scam app. Humanitarian responses, which is basically just garbage. It's in case something happens, they will be able to track and find you, including if you don't want anything injected in your body. E-commerce. You will not be able to shop online. Then you have social media platforms. You will literally need this ID in order to get TikTok, Twitter, or Facebook. No more fake accounts. You have e-government. So if you want your taxes done, any sort of benefits from there, you will need this. Then it gets even scarier. Telecommunications. You will not be able to actually get an internet provider without this digital ID, and they will be able to track you. And then up there you have smart cities, and we all know what those are. Those of you who think I'm lying, here's the federal condition in order for us to access our money, our tax money. This is basically a hostage situation of our tax money. And what you will see is instigators, government instigators under Twitter, under Justin Trudeau, that basically say we need to push our provincial governments to, you know, get the money so that we can spend it better. No, we don't. We actually need to call our provincial governments right now, today and tomorrow and every single day until they scrap this digital ID. They cannot pass this without our approval. So I need everybody in Canada to call your provincial governments and literally tell them that this is not going to happen. If we need to privatize, if we need to somehow get into a different system of healthcare, we need to do that. As for everyone in the United States, you're kind of lucky because your healthcare is privatized. There's also a lot more internet providers, some that will not go along with it because of capitalism. So your money.
And it's already on the books. that eventually you will have to have a digital tag, all right, to be tied to your health care. That was in the Obamacare plan, okay, which was fulfilled the promise, all right, that Creepy Joe back in, I believe, 2000 or 1990 something or early 2000 talked about. Eventually we will vote on the use of CHIPS for health purposes. All of this is coming to pass right before our very eyes, but there is so much confusion being put out there. All right, it's hard to see for certain people, but if you have eyes to see and ears to hear, and if you're just looking past the BS, you could see it, man. We already showed you what happened in Kenya. I believe that's next up.
He's actually speaking a lot louder in the United States, but Canada, this is coming down the pipeline, and it's coming down the pipeline fast, and we need to act.
Now, let me just put it blatantly to you. The program targets the birth of new babies. So once you have your baby, before your baby leaves the hospital, you no longer get a paper birth certificate, but then you get a digital one that is somehow implanted somewhere on somebody's body.
The digital ID.
The Kenyan president has sold his people out. We already showed you that, but let's just
finish. Which has been a big problem to us for a very long time, is now on a testing mode for the next 2 months. I have been assured by all the stakeholders, led by the ministries concerned, that by December, we will be able to launch digital ID.
Bill Gates is at it once again. Yep, this time he's in Kenya. You know, he's always testing in Africa, you know, testing AIDS. Because it didn't come from no green monkeys, because if it came from green monkeys, I have to say, who fucked the monkey, huh? Who was the monkey? Who fucked the monkey? It wasn't none of them niggas over there. We've been over there for centuries. Ain't never fucked the green monkey. One of them white people came over there playing Tarzan, Unkungawa, talk to the animals and shit. Been over there for centuries. Can't get sense out the mother. Anyway, Bill Gates is back at it. He's in Kenya. This mother testing out digital IDs, y'all. Hold on, check this out.
The program targets the birth of new babies. So once you have your baby, before your baby leaves the hospital, you no longer get a paper birth certificate, but then you get a digital one that is somehow implanted somewhere on somebody's body.
Can we say the mark of the beast?
Never listen to this.
So even he see it. See that? Even he see it.
The digital ID, which has been a big problem to us for a very long time, ministry is concerned.
Everybody get this shit underneath their skin. No more credit card. No more ID. We will track your every movement. If you're f***ing too fast, we will know this. If you're running too slow, we will know that. Also, if you get a bloody nose, we will know. 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 We will know if you're tile kicking. If you're f***ing an antelope, we will know it. And this motherfucker is supposed to be a president or something of Kenya. You sell out motherfucker. How are you gonna put your people subject to a Bill Gates experiment? And hey, don't accept that digital ID, because if you do, you accepting tyranny in your life.
Well, governments are there to protect us. And so, you know, they have us practice for earthquakes. You know, they have a fire department with lots of full-time people to stop fires. They have armies that are there to deal with wars. But the pandemic is a disaster that they didn't prepare for. The extra resources required to have a global surveillance team, to make better diagnostic technologies, to do quick detection, it's actually not going to be that expensive once the world gets organized and makes it a priority.
So active preparedness for the next pandemic, because as you said, it's not a matter of if, but when. How do we actively prepare? And are you seeing anywhere in the world where there's actual preparedness for a future pandemic right now?
Well, there's some good innovation. The idea of cheap diagnostics that you could literally produce billions of very quickly. So the innovation side, I think, is starting to move. But picking how we strengthen WHO, create a special organization dedicated to pandemics, you know, how we staff that, how we get every country to practice, you know, for fire. You've got fire drills, you've got signs. So we need a little bit of preparation so that we actually can stop something before it goes global. You know, so we'll have lots of outbreaks, but we don't need to have pandemics.
Right.
It's a disaster that they didn't prepare for. The actual resources required to have a global surveillance team to make better diagnostic technologies, to do quick detection. It's actually not going to be that expensive.
Yeah, we know what it's all leading towards, man. Okay? And Musk, going back to this nigga, right? These are Edomites. Look at this guy. This is an Edomite. They're bringing this system forth.
Ideas about what it means to be human. In 2016, Elon Musk founded Neuralink, a company whose goal is to connect the human brain to computers. The company is developing an ultra-high bandwidth brain chip to connect humans, computers, and artificial intelligence. What Musk refers to as a Fitbit in your skull with tiny wires. Appearing at a world government summit in 2017, Musk began singing from the same globalist hymn sheet, declaring that as humanity's dependence on technology increases...
The future of humanity depends on us merging with machines. What? Being transformed into their image.
Humans must simply merge with machines. Musk told the audience at the summit, to some degree, we are already a cyborg.
But having some sort of merger with...
Another meeting. And this is what they allow you to see.
Logical intelligence and machine intelligence. To some degree, we are already a cyborg. So some high bandwidth interface to the brain, I think, will be something that helps achieve a symbiosis and between human and machine intelligence, and maybe solves the control problem and the usefulness problem.
For Musk, becoming a cyborg, a superhuman with both biological and tech...
The control problem.
Technological powers is just one step away. Think Iron Man. We all love a good superhero movie, but anyone who's watched one knows what happens to the innocent bystanders. Mary Shelley warned us about this over 200 years ago. Later in his speech at the World Government Summit, Musk started revealing his true self, echoing the exact same sentiments as WF founder Klaus Schwab, who's long been obsessed with integrating machines into humanity to achieve godlike status.
Did you see that? To force public to wear brain implants so elite can read their minds. This is what they all into.
Who's long been obsessed with integrating machines into humanity to achieve godlike status. According to Schwab and his associates, God is dead, Jesus is fake news, and the elites are now turning themselves into gods.
I mean, all this story about Jesus rising from the dead and being the son of God, this is fake news.
Humans are now hackable animals. You know, the whole idea that humans have, you know, this, they have this soul or spirit and they have free will and nobody knows what's happening inside me. So whatever I choose, whether in the election or whether in the supermarket, this is my free will. That's over.
Musk explained that AI was progressing so rapidly that to become gods, humans would have to merge with digital intelligence to become a sort of AI-human hybrid. In 2020, Musk and Neuralink showcased their success in achieving a symbiosis between an animal and machine by implanting a chip in pigs, with humans as their next target. Musk bragged that Neuralink will one day allow people to upload, store, and retrieve memories between bodies and devices. Musk said, in the future, you'll be able to save and replay memories. This is obviously sounding increasingly like a Black Mirror episode, he continued. But
you can do that now.
Essentially, if you have a whole brain interface, everything that's encoded in memory, you could upload. So you could basically store your memories as a backup and restore the memories. Then, ultimately, you could potentially download them into a new body or into a robot body. If a memory can be downloaded and uploaded to a new body, it can most certainly be erased or otherwise altered. And here's the kicker. The victim will never know the difference. Thanks to young global leader Elon Musk's technological breakthroughs, Klaus Schwab's fourth industrial revolution will make no distinction between your digital, physical, or biological self. The elites will be gods, and ordinary people will be simply erased. It turns out that the key to losing weight and keeping...
All right, you could watch the rest of that. Enough was said there. Okay. And you best believe stuff like this is going to lead into them forcing this system. All right. All of these, you know, so-called assassinations, all of this, these shootings, gun control, they're going to eventually, it's going to get so crazy that they're going to be justified in bringing in a system where you give over your physical to their digital and merge yourself. Okay, but a lot of people are gonna have to be offed. But we'll talk about more of this so-called assassination attempt with this, which they're saying it's not. Well, we'll talk about this later, but you can clearly see things are heating up. Okay. NWO announced plan to use AI to deprogram, all right, C theorists. Again, this technology is being presented as cued as a way to help you, but this is their true plans are coming out. Okay, this technology is going to save the world from people who have particular thinking and talking points, religions. All right, it's going to be used to X out the Most High, all right, his son. okay? If you believe in, all right, conspiracy theories, a plan to be rooted out, and they're going to use AI and technology to do that, all right? And this is why they're so infatuated with getting control of the brain, okay? And this is not medical information. But as you can see there, the brain, the head is open. Who's sitting there controlling it? You see who that is. It's a small hat, okay? All right, no biometric data. Kuwait banks will freeze your account. Okay, let's see if we can find a video on that. I mean, or we could just read it, just read a little bit of it. Because we can clearly see where this is going, all right? Kuwait's banks sector is preparing to enforce biometric fingerprint technology across customer accounts, following a mandate from the Ministry of Interior. Where is this mandate coming from? All right. This system is going to be worldwide. Citizens who do not comply with the fingerprinting process by September 30th deadline will face an escalating restriction on their bank accounts and financial, all right, transactions. Eventually, it'll be deeper than a fingerprint. Right now, they're telling you won't be able to buy or sell or have access to your money if we don't have your fingerprint or biometric data, all right, by a particular deadline. Okay, banks are upgrading systems for biometric integration. Kuwait banks have started updating their systems to incorporate biometric fingerprint technology, a move driven by the Ministry of Interior's directive. Another, all right, you look these people up. Okay, who's the Ministry of Interior? Who the hell is that? All of these particular groups, just people, just an interior ministry is a governing ministry typically responsible for policing, emergency management, national security, all right, registration, supervision of local governments, United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia. All right, which we know they're going digital, right? Anyway, citizens must provide their biometric fingerprints by the end of September, or they will face significant consequences, including the suspension of all transactions with the Ministry of Interior. There you go. Starting this week, banks will send out notifications urging them to complete biometric fingerprint process. Starting to see when you log into certain accounts, because you got all these passwords, well, it's going to make it convenient to just use your fingerprint, right? Online transaction block from September 30th. Customers who have not provided their fingerprints will lose access to electronic services. This will prevent them from checking account balances, obtaining statements, and transferring funds online. Okay? We already know what this could lead to, right? You got the biometric update. You can read that website as always. As you saw there, Pakistan ID agency out after court violates constitution. Brazilian digital ID. I mean, everywhere you go. Okay, we know the EU. SIS biometric plot scale up the path. Biometric driver's license. Everywhere you look. Facial recognition back in crime fighting toolkit for Colorado police. Vita introduces biometric identity. Everywhere you look, digital IDs, how to accelerate global. All right, interoperability. All right. Philippine national ID card. So everywhere you look, all right, growing number of shops are going cashless, including major supermarket locations. I mean, Many retailers are banning cash from stores. Everything's going cashless. So eventually, you know, you'll be, you know, buying and selling with devices. All right, eventually device will be in you. It's very easy to see. Amazon wants your palm. TSA wants your face. All right, what saying yes will mean for the future? And you already said it when you went into the airport and you allowed them to take the picture. Eventually, they're going to have your fingerprint. All of this is going to be used to identify you in the new world, in the new system. Okay? After I chose a credit card to link to my palm, I visited a nearby Whole Foods and hovered my hand over a palm sensor checkout. Yada, yada, yada. We see where this is going. I mean, we're just showing you these articles to show you that this is happening worldwide, man. Touch-free. Evolution of touch-free. All right. Right now, pre-World War tech is shaping a payment revolution. Contactless, and this is MasterCard, and touch-free has gone from novelty to necessity in no time at all, thanks to accelerating innovation. It was a novel. It was something that was just talked about. Now, it's a necessity. Today, newer tech is changing how we live and work. Who knows where tomorrow may lead? Tomorrow is leading to the charagma. And one thing is clear, as time goes, the right technology and the right partner will be more important than ever for merchants, MasterCard, white label solutions, and digital enablement to allow every business to ride the wave of innovation with minimal cost. And it just shows you how it's grown from 1966, 75, 83, 93 to 94, cards with chips in them, RFID, 97, RFID payments introduced in the U.S., RFID implanted within humans in 2001. All right, 2003, MasterCard initiates payment by implant. 2006, first enabled phone, Nokia. 2007, first UK contactless payments launched. Now we're here. All right, 2014, Apple Pay, Android Pay, first debit pay in 2017 via RFID chips. NatWest trials first biometric payment card, 2019. 2020 was the C ragamuffin. All right, the Crown Royale, 2019. Now, that gave them the go-ahead to start to implement this system worldwide. Okay? Because now we need to be able to identify people. We need a system where we can know who has what. We can know who believes in what. We can track, trace, whatever. Contactless card. All right. And now we're here. Okay? Amazon One Palm biometric payment. 2001, MasterCard launches biometric payment. It's showing you the gradualism of this system. Okay? Implants for payments. See that? They're showing you on the website. The future, touch-free, cash-free. 21 to 29, they want wearable, allowable biometric payments using your heartbeat. Smartwatches. Medical implant usages. Implant payments. Wearable devices. Yada, yada, yada. CAS zero drops to near zero. So, how in the hell can we separate what we're seeing happening right before our very eyes from what John the Revelator prophesied here in Revelation? And why are camps, all right, going so hard, okay, to aid in you not linking these things together? I don't know. Have they sold out? Either way, hopefully y'all are edified. I know it's a lot of information, but those articles, you can pause it, look them up. Those videos, you can pause them and look them up. There's other videos I had too, but it's just so much information, you know, that... You know, you'll just have to look these things up on your own. But the stage is being set. Do you know what I'm saying? The stage is being set. Hopefully y'all are edified on to the next Shalom.